Dear students, welcome to this video. Today we'll be discussing differentiation from first principle. You know, to get the derivative with the help of definition of the differentiation is known as first principle. So let us start with this result from first principle. Prove that the derivative of x to the power n is n x to the power n minus 1. So let us suppose that here y is a function denoted by xn. So we have to find here derivative of y with respect to x. Let delta y be a small change in y and delta x be a corresponding change in x. So we can write y plus delta y is equal to x plus delta x to the power n from this expression. So let us write here relation 1, here relation 2. Now 2 minus 1 gives us delta y is equal to x plus delta x whole to the power n minus x to the power n, and delta y by delta x is equal to x plus delta x to the power n minus x to the power n divided by delta x. And as you know, derivative of y with respect to x, this is limit delta x tends to 0 delta y by delta x. So this will be equal to limit delta x tends to 0 x plus delta x whole to the power n minus x to the power n divided by delta x. Now in place of delta x tends to 0, we can write x plus delta x tends to x, and here in place of delta x we can write x plus delta x minus x. So we can arrange this expression here like this. So after this step we can write derivative of y with respect to x is equal to here limit x plus delta x tends to x, and here x plus delta x whole to the power n minus x to the power n divided by x plus delta x minus x. So we have arranged this expression in this way since we know a result that limit x tends to a x to the power n minus a to the power n upon x minus a, this is equal to n into a to the power n minus 1. So we have arranged this expression in this format: limit x plus delta x tends to x, x plus delta x to the power n minus x to the power n, x plus delta x minus x. After comparing this result, we find here that in place of x, we have x plus delta x, and in place of x, we have a. So with the help of this result, now we are getting result here directly n into a to the power n minus 1. So n in place of a, we have to write x, x to the power n minus 1. So now we are getting the result. This is the result. So it has been proved now. Now next question. Question number 2. from first principle prove that d dx of e to the power x is equal to e to the power x. We will proceed here in the same pattern as we have done in the first question. So let us see here solution. Let y is equal to e to the power x. So this gives us y plus delta y is equal to e to the power x plus delta x. Suppose this is relation 1 and this is relation 2. So here 2 minus 1 gives us delta y is equal to e to the power e x plus delta x minus e to the power x. And therefore delta y by delta x is equal to e to the power x plus delta x minus e to the power x divided by delta x. Now we can take common e to the power x from each of these two terms in the numerator. So this is equal to, we are taking e to the power x common, e to the power delta x minus 1 divided by delta x. Now we have to find out derivative of y with respect to x. This will be equal to limit delta x tends to 0, this part e to the power x, e to the power delta x minus 1 by delta x. And this is equal to e to the power x. Here e to the power x is free from delta x, so we can write it separately, e to the power x into limit delta x tends to 0 delta x minus 1 by delta x. As we know the result, e to the power delta x, as we know the result, e to the power x minus 1 by x and limit x tends to 0, this is equal to 1. So by using this result here, we can write this is equal to e to the power x. So finally we are getting here dy by dx is equal to e to the power x. Proved. Now let us see derivative of some trigonometrical ratio from first principle. Next question. From first principle, prove that derivative of sine x with respect to x, this is cos x. So let us suppose y is a function sine x. Suppose this is relation 1. Therefore, we can write y plus delta y is equal to sine x plus delta x. Relation 2. As you know, delta x is a small change in x and delta y is the corresponding change in y. Now, subtracting relation 1 from 2 gives us y plus delta y minus y is equal to sine of x plus delta x minus sine x. That plus y and minus y will be cancelled out. And you know, d dx of y, derivative of y with respect to x, this is limit delta x tends to 0 dy by dx. So from here we can write limit delta x tends to 0 sine of x plus delta x minus sine of x upon delta x. We are dividing both sides by delta x. Now we can use a trigonometrical formula here, sine of c minus sine of d. For this numerator, sine c minus sine d, you know, this is equal to 2 cos c plus d by 2 into sine c minus d by 2. So with the help of this result here, we can write this is equal to limit delta x tends to 0, 2 cos c plus d by 2 means 2 cos x plus delta x plus x means x plus delta x by 2, 2 cos c plus d by 2, and sine c minus d by 2, c minus d means x plus delta x minus x. So this will be sine delta x by 2 divided by delta x. Now we can replace this 2 by writing 2 here. Now we have to take the limit. So this is equal to limit delta x tends to 0. Breaking this expression in two parts, we can write first part will be cos of x plus delta x by 2 limit of this much plus limit delta x tends to 0 sine delta x by 2 upon delta x by 2. So you know this formula, limit x tends to 0 sine x by x, this is equal to 1. So with the help of this result, we are getting this much is equal to, sorry, here in 2 is here, multiplication is here. We are getting this much is equal to 1, and here delta x is 0. So finally you will get cos x here. So this is equal to cos x. So finally we are getting the result, derivative of y with respect to x, this is equal to cos x. Now let us see one more trigonometrical ratio. From the first principle, prove that derivative of cos x with respect to x, this is equal to minus sin x. The same pattern will follow here also. So let us suppose that y be a function cos x relation 1, and therefore y plus delta y is equal to cos of x plus delta x, relation number 2. So relation number 2 minus 1 gives us delta y is equal to cos of x plus delta x minus cos of x. And therefore delta y by delta x is equal to this much divided by delta x. And therefore derivative of y with respect to x, this is limit delta x tends to 0 delta y by delta x. This is limit delta x tends to 0 cos of x plus delta x minus cos of x upon delta x. Now we can use a trigonometrical formula here, cos c minus cos d. Cos c minus cos d, this is equal to 2 sine c plus d by 2 into sine d minus c by 2. And in place of d minus c by 2, if you write c minus d by 2 here, if you write c minus d by 2, then you have to take a negative sign here. So now let us use this formula here, and after using this formula we can write this is equal to limit delta x tends to 0 minus of 2 into sine c plus d by 2 means sine x plus delta x plus x divided by 2 into sine of c minus d by 2 in sine of x plus delta x minus x divided by 2. Here plus x and minus x will be cancelled out. So we will take this minus sign here, minus limit delta x tends to 0 2 times into x plus x is 2x divided by 2. So this is sine x plus delta x by 2 into sine of delta x by 2. So finally we have to write a divided by delta x also. This will be delta x. Now let us arrange this expression. This is minus limit delta x tends to 0. This 2 can be written here also, delta x by 2, like this. So this becomes sine of x plus delta x by 2 upon delta x by 2, and limit x tends to 0 sine of delta x by 2 upon delta x by 2. Now you see, we are having delta x by 2 and we are writing delta x by 2 here, so we will not write delta x by 2 here. And this is equal to this delta x tends to 0. So finally we are getting here minus of sine x, and by the trigonometrical formula with limit x tends to 0, sine delta x by 2 divided by delta x by 2, this is equal to 1, as we have seen in the previous question also. So finally we are getting the result, this is minus sine x. So derivative of cos x with respect to x is equal to minus sine x. This is proved. Similarly, we can prove some more results from first principle, like derivative of tan x with respect to x, this is equal to sec square x. Derivative of sec x with respect to x, this is sec x into tan x. Derivative of cosec x with respect to x, this is minus cosec x into cot x. And derivative of cot x is equal to minus cosec square x. So in the similar pattern as we have done first two questions, we can prove these results also. In addition to these results, before coming to the problems related to first principle, we must remember that note that derivative of any constant with respect to any variable x, this is equal to 0. Similarly, derivative of constant times of any function with respect to x is equal to constant into derivative of fx with respect to x. Next, derivative with respect to x, sum of two functions fx plus gx, this can be written as derivative plus derivative of gx with respect to x. So these are the basic concepts of differentiation from first principle. Now in the next video we will see some problems related to this topic. So dear students, thank you for watching this video, and I hope you might be getting benefit from my videos. So please give a like and subscribe my channel Anand Misra, so that I can give you update in time. and please share this video with your friends also, so that they also could benefit from it. Thank you very much.